Let's suppose someone came into your house, threw trash in it and left. How would you feel? Angry probably. But what if I tell you that this happens to all of us every single day? The places we live, the places we visit, the oceans, the forests, the cities, all these places are being polluted by millions of tons of trash every single day. But the irony is that we are the ones suffering from this, but in the same time we are the ones causing it. Our planet is being polluted by lots of ways, but for now let's just talk about plastic. And the reason I want to talk about plastic is because it has been part of our lives. Like, it is so common that I bet you that if you see around yourself right now watching this video, you'd find lots of things made up of plastic. Like the phone or the PC you are using contains plastic, you might be sitting on plastic, you might be wearing plastic, and there would be lot other things which I probably don't know about. But lots of time we need a certain plastic for few minutes in our life. But that plastic harms our planet for centuries to come. Let's take this bag of chips for instance. You take it, you open it, you eat the chips out of it, and you throw the plastic bag away. How much time does it take? 5 minutes. But most of the time, this plastic bag lies somewhere in our planet for hundreds of years. Yes, because this plastic bag takes around 450 to 1000 years to decompose. And these kinds of plastic items affect us doesn't matter where we dump it. Like, if we dump it in the sea, it affects marine life, like fishes, turtles, shrimps, and probably all the marine life. But we humans eat seafood, and if that seafood is affected by plastic, we are also affected with it. And if not sea, if we dump this plastic in landfills, it might affect the soil and the crops growing around that plastic. And we eat those crops. So again, plastic ended up in our food chain. And if we straight up just burn the plastic, it emits toxic chemical in air. And we breathe that air. Plastic doesn't just affect humans, it affects all the living organisms living in this planet. Over 1 million animals die every year because of plastic. Like, look at these birds. All these birds died because of eating plastic. Because they misinterpreted plastic with food. They thought that that shiny looking thing is food. Actually, it's poison for them. When researchers tried to cut open some of the birds, they found whole chunks of plastic in their stomach, undigested. And we have heard of lot of stories of whales being found on seashore filled with plastic. So with all these, we should probably ban plastic, right? Actually, banning plastic could be more harmful for the environment because of some misconceptions we have. Like, we think that instead of using plastic bags, if we use cotton bag, it would be good for environment. But actually, it's not that simple, because plastic bags take far less energy to produce than cotton bags. So while production, it emits less carbon dioxide than cotton bags. So to make cotton bags better than plastic bags, we have to use one cotton bag at least 7,100 times. Yes, 7,100 times. And this is not just about cotton bags. All the hard reusable alternatives for plastic like glass, wood, we have to use them again and again to make them better than plastic. Do you know that for past few years, lots of companies are experimenting with plastic clothes? Like, they take used plastic, grind them, clean them, and make clothes out of it. So it looks really good, right? Means no plastic is ending up in ocean or landfills. It is purely recycled. But actually, these plastic clothes also have some downsides, and those can prove disastrous. Because we wash clothes, and while washing those plastic clothes, they emit microplastic. And this microplastic can be so small that humans can't see it. But it mixes with our water, and that water eventually ends up in ocean. And in that ocean, this microplastic is eaten by microorganisms, which we can't see either. Then those microorganisms are eaten by small fishes. Then those small fishes are eaten by bigger fishes. And this chain continues until it comes back to human. Another reason we cannot ban plastic is because at certain points we just not eat plastic for convenience, we literally need it. Like syringes, medicine and other medical equipment cannot be stored without plastic. And every year 1/3 of the global food gets rotten and turns into the garbage. And now if you stop storing food in plastic, the wastage of food might even increase more, which is clearly not good. So if plastic is famous, it is for a reason. But is there no way out of it? Actually, there is. There are a lot of companies who are working on this problem, and some of them have succeeded to found some alternatives. But those alternatives are not perfect yet. Some of them are not durable enough, while some of them are expensive. So it would probably still take 50 to 60 years to make an alternative which is equally durable and cheap as plastic. So what you and I can do to help solve this problem? Being honest, we cannot completely stop using plastic. But what we can do is decrease the use of it. We should stop using single-use plastic as much as possible, like plastic cups, plastic straws, and plastic spoons. We can avoid them. They are manageable. But the best thing we can do right now is recycling plastic. But loss of time making new plastic is far more easier than recycling the old ones. But we can help it by sorting out. Because lots of time plastic gets mixed up with other garbage, and this makes it harder to be recycled. But if we put plastic in separate bags or separate baskets, it would make the recycling of plastic far easier. And I think that is the best thing we can do right now. But if you have any better idea, tell me in the comment section. And if you found this video interesting and helpful, like, comment, share, subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next week.